Hi everyone, I'm meteorologist Jared Heil with another video weather blog update for you only here at WLKY.com, where we update you on not only the short-term forecast, but going forward in time and looking into our early winter season as to whether or not any big storms are on the horizon. The big thing this weekend, though, mild temperatures, highs in the 60s today, upper 50s yesterday, and more energy is heading in our direction. It's going to interact with that warm air and bring us rain and storm chances. By the time we get into our Monday, more rain toward the south tonight on this Sunday evening. But notice the spin here in this cloud cover really developing over portions of the eastern plains, heading toward areas like Springfield, Missouri, and Little Rock, Arkansas. That is upper low pressure, and that's going to ride up over a stationary frontal boundary on our Monday. So more rain chances are in the offing. It's not going to be a heavy rain all day long, but scattered showers and a few rumbles of thunder will be with us for your Monday plan, so keep that in mind. Temperatures behind this boundary, you can tell where it's cooling off. You have the greens and yellows here. That's the warm stuff, 50s and 60s. Then toward the north and west, much colder. That dark blue shade is under freezing, and the teens there in the pink. So it's pretty cold in the northern tier, but it's really going to take several days to get that chilly weather into this part of the country. So let's look ahead now on your long-range forecast. I've put together some forecast models and painted on the jet stream for you to show you where things are stacking up in the weather patterns right now. Anything bright in terms of these oranges or greens indicate above normal temperatures for the most part. These blues, that indicates more of an unsettled, colder pattern, and that is what we're going to be watching as we go forward on this forecast. The white is the jet stream, and as we look out there today, you can see the big ridge on the eastern U.S. That's why we are so mild, and it is obviously colder toward the west and northwest. Going forward, though, by the time we get toward our Wednesday, we'll get this storm system out of here. Tuesday's a cooler day, highs in the upper 40s and low 50s, but the ridge moves back in quickly in this progressive pattern by our Wednesday, and we'll see high temperatures approaching the upper 50s, actually, by your Wednesday afternoon with partly sunny skies anyway. But notice a couple of features off toward the west. Big storm system in the Four Corners region, also more energy just toward the south of Alaska, so more active weather is heading for the lower 48. Watch what happens. By your Friday and your Thursday time frame, another storm system gathers strength and heads toward our area. The rain chances with this system get here on Thursday, and notice I'm mentioning rain, not snow. This is a warm weather system for us. If you're looking for snow, it could be heavy and potentially blizzard-like in northern Illinois back toward Wisconsin by Thursday afternoon. But around here, it's just rain, but it will turn sharply colder as that dip in the jet stream digs in here for your Friday with highs only in the 30s. The ridge is building back in, though, in the middle part of the country, and the cold air is bottled out toward the west for the most part. So after a couple of chilly days for Friday, Saturday, and even into Sunday, I think this ridge will build back in by the time we approach Christmas Eve and Christmas Day. And I still don't really think a lot of cold weather is in the offing for the holiday period there on your Monday and Tuesday of next week. And then, by the time we get toward the day past Christmas, this is the following Wednesday, the 26th, another piece of energy is riding through the jet stream. We could see more rain and storms, but once again, this does not look like a snowmaker because there's just not a whole lot of cold air until you get behind the cold front. And after you get behind these cold fronts, as you know, the dry air filters in and the precipitation shuts off. Also notice here as well, we've got one, two, three systems across the continental U.S. and North America. It's a progressive pattern, so the cold air or the warm air doesn't last very long before it kind of swaps back and forth with this active forecast as we approach the end of 2012. This is the actual temperature anomaly, the difference in temperature compared to normal. The blue is cold, the green is warm compared to average on the 26th, the day after Christmas here. And you can tell, even with that storm system heading our way, look at that. The temperatures are at or above average. The cold air is off toward the west. So the big question is, as we approach the new year and head into early January, is that going to change? Well, this model comes out every day. We watch it very closely. It's called the CFS model. You can see that shade of blue right there. This is from December 30th through January 5th. It indicates that behind that next system, a good shot of cold air would head our way, especially toward the first part of 2013 there, around the 1st through the 3rd or 4th, and the warm air is suppressed off toward the south. What happens after that? Well, this model wants to keep us fairly chilly and actually brings in the cold air and keeps it here for several days into early January, but notice the cutoff is still right at the Gulf Coast. So if this happens, could turn out to be fairly cold around here, but it's very early to tell. And obviously, if some energy were to ride up through this cold air, we could see some decent snowfall. It's just far too early to tell. So here's the bottom line, what we're looking at. The milder periods Wednesday and Thursday around Christmas as well could be relatively mild. The colder periods just after Christmas, we're looking at the holidays, they're also Friday through Sunday. That's the first cold snap coming. And then potentially there in early January with some cold weather. But in terms of snowfall, sorry about that. No big chances of snow showing up at this time that we can really grasp our attention toward. We'll watch it real close, and especially if that cold snap hits in early January, that could set us up for some wintry or possibly even icy weather if things stack up perfectly or imperfectly, depending on your opinion. Come right back here at WLKY.com for more on your video blog. Jay and myself and everyone else will update it almost daily for you through the winter season and keep you updated. Have a great night.